In this lecture, we are going to discuss the topic energetics of alpha decay. So in this article, we are going to find what is the energy of alpha particle which is emitted from alpha emitter. So let's say we are considering the equation of alpha decay. So we know alpha particle, it is nothing but helium nucleus, and in helium nucleus there are two protons and two neutrons. So when alpha particle is decayed, it is emitted from a nucleus. So let's say we have parent nucleus, which is given by X, and it has mass number is equal to capital A and its atomic number is equal to capital Z. So when alpha decay happens, this parent nuclei, it decays to daughter nucleus whose mass number decreases by 4 and proton number decreases by 2, and alpha particle is emitted, plus some energy is released during this decay process. So this energy which is released in alpha decay, it is called as Q value. So this is called as Q value of the decay process. So this energy which is released during this decay, it is distributed between the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle, because the energy which is released, it has to be given to the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle. So alpha particle, it gets some energy, and the daughter nucleus also gets some amount of energy. So the summation of the total energies which is imparted to the daughter nucleus as well as to the alpha particle is called as the Q value of the alpha decay process. So when alpha decay occurs, energy Q is released, which is distributed between the daughter nuclei and the alpha particle. So the Q value, this energy Q, whatever amount of energy is released during this decay process, it is distributed between the daughter nucleus. So some kinetic energy is given to daughter nucleus and the rest of the energy is given to the alpha particle as its kinetic energy. So in this article, we will find the relation of what is the kinetic energy of the alpha particle which is released. So alpha particle, it will get some kinetic energy, and we are going to find out what is that, what is the expression of the kinetic energy which is imparted to the alpha particle. Obviously, this energy which is released, what is the reason of this release of energy? This is due to the difference in the mass of the parent and the products. So the reactants and the products, due to the difference in the masses of the reactants and the products, this energy is released. So the mass of the parent nuclei, it must be greater than the sum of the masses of daughter as well as the alpha particle. So what is this Q energy? It is, this energy is equal to difference in the masses of the reactants and the products times C square, because this is the energy. So energy is equal to mass times C square. So Q is equal to delta M times C square. So what is this delta M? This is the difference in the masses of the reactants and the products. So this will be equal to mass of the parent nucleus minus of the mass of the product. So what are the products? It is the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle. So minus of the summation of the masses of the products, which is mass of Y plus mass of alpha particle. So this is the difference in the masses of the reactants and the products times C square. So this amount of energy is, so this amount of energy, it is released during the alpha decay process, and this is only the reason why energy is released during any nuclear reaction. This energy is released due to the difference in the masses. The masses of the products, it is less as compared to the mass of the reactants, and that difference in the mass, it is released in the form of energy, and that energy can be found out using the Einstein's mass energy equivalent relation, which is E is equal to mc square. And keep in mind, this energy is released, it is due to the difference in the masses of the reactants and the products. And also, The alpha decay process, it is possible only when the energy released is the positive value. The energy which is released, it has positive value, only then alpha decay process will occur. So that will occur when mass of the parent nucleus, it is greater than the sum of the masses of the products. So Q value, it will be positive only when Mx will be greater than My plus M alpha. So this Mx, it will be greater than the combined mass of the daughter and the alpha particle. So that will give us a positive value of Q. So that will give us positive value of energy. So only then alpha decay process occurs. As we had said, the Q value, it is the energy which is released in the alpha decay process, and this energy released, it is due to the difference in the masses of the reactants and the products. And this energy which is released, it is distributed between the daughter and the alpha particle in the form of kinetic energy. So Q value which is released, it will be given, some proportion will be given to alpha particle as its kinetic energy, and some portion of this Q value, it will be given to the daughter nucleus as its kinetic energy. So we have written the kinetic energy of alpha particle as Ke alpha, or you can also write T alpha. So kinetic energy, in some books it is denoted by capital T. So you can write Q is equal to T alpha plus Ty. This is the kinetic energy of the daughter nucleus. And the last expression that we had written, Q value is equal to Mx minus of My plus M alpha times C square. So this is another formula of finding the Q value. So in this diagram I have shown over here, this is the parent nucleus X. So parent nucleus X, it is at rest, so velocity of the parent nucleus is equal to zero, and this parent nucleus, it will have some mass, let's say that is Mx. Now when the alpha decay process occurs, the parent nucleus, it decays into the daughter nucleus Y, and alpha particle is released. So the alpha particle, it will have some mass, let's say that is M alpha, and velocity of the alpha particle will be V alpha. As we have said, the Q value, the energy which is released, it is given as kinetic energy. So the alpha particle will have some velocity, and the daughter nucleus will also have some velocity. So the mass of the daughter nucleus is given by My, and let's say its velocity is given by Vy. So now we will apply the conservation of linear momentum in this case. So in this first case, in this first diagram, when there is only parent nucleus, so when no decay has occurred, no alpha particle has been emitted, so then what is the momentum in this first case? So velocity of the parent nucleus is equal to zero, and linear momentum P is given by mass into velocity. So if velocity is zero, the momentum of this parent nucleus will be equal to zero. So in this first diagram, the momentum, initial momentum, is equal to zero, and what is the final momentum? That is when the alpha decay process has occurred, X has decayed to Y, and alpha particle has been released. So what is the final momentum in this case? So final momentum will be equal to MyVy, so mass into velocity, plus mass into velocity of the alpha particle. So we have done the vector addition of both these momentums. And we have done the vector addition because the velocities, they are the vector quantity. Now masses, these are the scalar quantities, but velocities, they are the vector quantity. So momentum of the daughter nucleus will be given by My into Vy vector, plus the momentum of the alpha particle will be given by M alpha into V alpha vector. So summation of the both momentum will give us the final momentum in this case, when the alpha particle has been emitted, or you can say when alpha decay has occurred. So this will be the final momentum. So this final momentum is equal to initial momentum. This is what the conservation of linear momentum is. So conservation of linear momentum is, it states that the momentum the total momentum before the collision is equal to total momentum after the collision. So before the alpha decay process, the momentum was equal to zero, and after the alpha decay process, the total momentum is equal to my vy vector plus m alpha v alpha vector. So this equation we have got by using the conservation of linear momentum. So from here we can get the expression of the velocity of the daughter nucleus Vy vector. So it will come out to be equal to minus of m alpha divided by my. So you can simplify this equation and you will get this equation. So this will give us the relation of the velocity of daughter nucleus and the velocity of the alpha particle. So one thing you can note over here, that we have a negative sign over here. So this means that the direction of Vy is opposite to that of the direction of V alpha, which means the velocity of the daughter nucleus and the velocity of the alpha particle, they are anti-parallel, or you can say they are opposite to each other. So in terms of magnitude, if we ignore the negative sign, only in terms of magnitude, we can say Vy will be equal to m alpha divided by my into V alpha. So this is the relation of Vy, velocity of the daughter nucleus, with the velocity of the alpha particle. So now we are going to see what will be the Q value. So the end result we want to find is the kinetic energy of the alpha particle. We want to find the relation of the kinetic energy of the alpha particle. So total energy which is released, the Q value, it is equal to Ty plus T alpha, because it is distributed between the daughter nucleus and the alpha particle in terms of their kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is given by half mv square. So the kinetic energy of the daughter nucleus, it will be half into mass of the daughter nucleus into square of the velocity of the daughter nucleus. So that will be my into vy square divided by 2. Then the kinetic energy of the alpha particle, it will be equal to half times mass of the alpha particle into square of the velocity of the alpha particle. So now we will use the expression of vy that we had evaluated in the last step. So vy is equal to, so we will write half times my into vy square. Now what is vy? It is equal to m alpha divided by my into v alpha whole square. So we have used this expression of vy in this first term, plus half times m alpha into v alpha square. So from here you can calculate half times my into m alpha square into v alpha square divided by my square plus half of m alpha into v alpha square. So from here you can cancel my with 1my in the denominator, and m alpha and v alpha square, m alpha v alpha square and divide by 2 is common in both the terms. So you can get it is equal to half of m alpha into v alpha square. So here you have taken common m alpha v alpha square. So 1 m alpha it will be left, divide by my will be left behind in the first term, plus 1. So Q value of this alpha decay will be equal to half m alpha v alpha square times this expression. Now what is this term, half m alpha v alpha square? It is nothing but the kinetic energy of the alpha particle. So this will be equal to T alpha. And we will simplify this expression. It will be equal to m alpha plus my divided by my. So from here you can find what is the expression of T alpha, which is the kinetic energy of the alpha particle. So it will be equal to, kinetic energy of the alpha particle will be equal to, so on the left hand side we have Q and on the right hand side we have T alpha into m alpha plus my divided by my. So T alpha will be equal to my divided by m alpha plus my into Q. So this is the expression of relation of kinetic energy of alpha particle with the energy which is released during the alpha decay process. Now the mass of the daughter nucleus. So this proportionality, this equation, it will be equal to mass of the daughter nucleus. It is equal to A minus 4 divided by mass of the alpha particle is equal to 4. So as we had written in the first, in the starting of this article, we had written the mass of the daughter nucleus, it decreases by 4, and the mass and the atomic number of the daughter nucleus, it decreases by 2. Now mass of the alpha particle, the mass number is given by 4 plus mass my, it will be A minus 4 times Q. So from this expression, when you will evaluate it, when you will simplify it, then T alpha, it will be equal to A minus 4 divided by 4 plus A minus 4, that will be divided by A into Q. So this is the final expression of the relation of the kinetic energy of alpha particle with the Q value, or you can say with the energy which is released during the alpha decay process. So alpha decay process, it occurs only when Q value is positive. As we have discussed already, the Q value is equal to mx minus the sum of the masses of the products times C square. So when Q value is positive, then so for the positive value of Q, mass of the parent nucleus, it must be greater than the sum of the masses of the products. The alpha decay process, it occurs only when energy is released. So if energy will be released, only then alpha decay occurs. Now for radium-222, as an example we are taking radium-222, its mass number is equal to 222, and we are given that the energy which is released during the alpha decay of radium is 5.587 mega electron volt. So this is the total energy which is released during the alpha decay process of radium-222, and we want to find what is the kinetic energy of the alpha particle which is released. So kinetic energy of alpha particle is given by A minus 4 divided by A. Now A, it is the mass number of the parent nucleus. So keep in mind, capital A over here, it is the mass number of the parent nucleus. It is not the mass number of the daughter nucleus. So keep in mind, it is the mass number of the parent nucleus. So for kinetic energy of the alpha particle, it will be equal to A minus 4. So parent nucleus is radium-222, its mass number is 222. So A will be equal to 222 minus 4 divided by 222 into Q. Now what is Q? It is 5.587 mega electron volt. So when you will solve it, you will get kinetic energy will be equal to 5.486 mega electron volt. So this is the kinetic energy that you will get of the alpha particle which is released by radium-222. As you can see, the total energy which is released is 5.587, and the energy which is given to the alpha particle. So from this energy which is released, some energy will be taken by the alpha particle as its kinetic energy, and some of the energy will be taken, rest of the energy will be taken by the daughter nucleus as its kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy that we have found, the kinetic energy which is taken by the alpha particle, it comes out to be 5.486, and total energy released is 5.587. So you can say that most of the energy which is released in the alpha decay process, so most of the energy released is taken by the alpha particle as its kinetic energy. So as capital A will increase, as you are moving to the heavy nuclei, then kinetic energy of the alpha particle, it will come very close to the total energy which is released. So in this case also, the kinetic energy of the alpha particle, it is 5.486 mega electron volt, and total energy which is released, it is 5.587 mega electron volt. So this is approximately equal to, it is very close to the total energy released. So as the mass number is increased. As we are moving to heavy nuclei, the kinetic energy of the alpha particle which is emitted by that heavy nuclei, it will come approximately close to the total energy released, which means that majority of the energy released is taken by the alpha particle as its kinetic energy, and very little amount of energy is taken by the daughter nucleus.